Hello everyone, welcome back again to Mufazuke channel with GWCAD basic tutorial how to create a simple 2D floor plan. Okay, first I will create a new drawing, you can click here. And next I will use a GWCAD ISO template, this is in millimeter, you can click open. Okay, in here I will create a rectangle object. Okay, start from this point and I will use a dimension for length 6000, okay, and for width 10000. Okay, next I will use offset command, you can type offset, we give offset a distance 150. Okay, you can click this object and click insert. Use explode command, okay, to explode this object, and then I will use trim command to cut to extend this line, and we extend again in here. Okay, you can select this line object and delete. Okay, next we can use copy command to copy this line object to the top here for 1050. Okay, we copy again this line object to the top, 2750, and then we copy 1200. Okay, you can copy again this line object to the right here, 3075. Okay, next I will use trim command to cut this line object, and we cut in here. Okay, you can create line start from this point into this point, and next you can move the last object to the top 5000. Enter. Okay, use offset command. Okay, I will use offset command with offset distance 150. Okay, I will offset this line object and offset to the left here. Okay, we can create line object. Okay, start from this point into this point, and you can move the last object to the left here, 1100. Okay, and you can use a trim command to cut this line object and cut in here. Okay, I will copy this line object to the left point 150, and next you can use offset command with offset distance 75. Okay, I will offset this line object to the top and to the bottom, we offset again in here. Okay, in here, in here, and the last in here. Okay, you can select middle line and then delete. Okay, we select and delete. And in here I will use trim command. Okay, we extend this line, and then I will cut in here. Okay, we cut in this point. Okay, cut in here, in here. Okay, we cut one by one, cut in here and in here. Okay, you can select this line object and delete. Next I will create a line. Okay, you can sort at this point and move to the bottom here, 700. Move to the left, 1300. Okay, and click at this point. Okay. Next, we can use a hatch command. You can type hatch, enter, and I will change samples in here into NC. You can click at this pattern. Okay, and for pick point I will select at this region. Okay, you can enter, Next, for scale, I will use 15. And you can preview in here. Okay, this for scale 15. And click OK to apply. Okay. And next, we can insert a door into this floor plan. But first, I will change this head. Okay, I will change color. You can use select a color in here, and I will change into this color. You can click OK. Next, I will use block to insert door into this floor plan. You can type insert, enter. Okay, you can get this block from our download links in below this video. You can browse in here. And for door, I will change view into thumbnails. And next, I will use this door, open, insert, and I will attach in here. Okay, I will change the wipeout frame into 0 to make this transparent. You can tap wipeout, enter, and tap F for a frame. Next, you can tap off, enter. Okay, it will be hide. Next, we can use a copy command, okay, to copy this object into this point. And then we can use a rotate command to rotate this object. Okay. Next, I will move this object start from this point into this point. Okay. You can use a mirror command to mirror this object from this point to the right here. And you can move this object start from this point into this point. Next, we insert again a new door dimension. Okay, I will use this door and open. I will insert in here. You can use mirror command to mirror this object to this point. Okay, I will delete this object. Next, we can use rotate command to rotate this door. Start from this point to this point. And then I will move this object from this point into this point. Okay, we already attached a door into this floor plan. Next, we insert windows. You can type insert and then search for a window block. Okay, I will use this windows option. You can click open, insert, and click at this point. Okay, I will edit this block. Okay, next for this object, I will send to back. You can draw order and bring send to back. Okay, you can click close a block editor, and yes, we can move this block object start from a middle point. Okay, and I will use M2P option. We click in here and then click again in here. Okay, I will copy. Okay, we copy this block into here. Okay, we copy to object, and you can move this object from this point into this point. Next, we move these two objects from this point into middle point in here. Okay, we already insert a door and block. Next, I will insert in here for a bed. Okay, you can type insert again and search for a bed block. Okay, I will use this block, open, insert. I will insert in here. Okay, we insert again another bed. Okay, I will open, insert in here. Okay, you can use rotate command to rotate this object. Okay, 180 degree. And next, I will use a move command to move this block start from this point into this point. We move again this block. from this point into this point. Okay, next we insert a kitchen furniture. You can use insert a command and we search for kitchen stuff. Okay, I will insert this objects. Okay, I will put in here, we insert again this stuff and we insert the last refrigerator block in here. Okay, you can use a rotate command to rotate this object. Okay, next I will edit this block. Okay, and you can use a trim command to cut in here and delete this line object. You can close a block editor and click yes. Move this object stuff from this point into this point, and I will move this two object from this point into this point. Okay, we move again this refrigerator block into this point. Okay, next for WC or toilet, I will insert new block. Okay, we insert for bedroom and toilet seat. Okay, you can click open, insert, and I will apply in here. Okay, the last we insert for living room furniture. You can tap insert and browse for sofa. Okay, I will insert this block. Open, insert. Okay, you can click at this point. Next, you can edit this block. Okay, I will delete this object. We delete in here, and I will create a rectangle. Okay, this for table. We create in here. Next, you can close block editor. Yes, and use a rotate command to rotate this objects. And now you can move this object from this point into this point. Okay. Next, I will use multi-line text to create text into this floor plan. You can tap M text. Okay. And next, I will create in here. For example, I will type garage. Okay, I will garage. Click enter. Okay, you can click this object. You can select this object, and then change this scale text height in here into 150. Okay. Next, I will change color into this text into green. Okay, you can move command. Use a move command to move this text, and I will use a copy. Okay, to copy this object stuff from this point, we copy in here. Copy again in here. Okay, in here. Copy in here, in here, and then the last in here. Okay, you can change this name into garden. Okay, we change in here into living room. Okay, in here WC. Okay, this for bedroom 1, and in here bedroom 2, the last kitchen. Okay, next I will use a hatch command to apply hatch into this region. You can type a hatch. Okay, and for pattern in here, I will search for another pattern. Okay, we search for this cross. Okay, this for a garden, and you can use another pattern for a garage. Okay, in here I will use what pattern? Okay, we use this pattern. It's okay, or you can use this pattern. Okay, I will use this pattern. Okay, and then add the pick points. I will click in here. Enter. Next, you can change scales in here into 40. You can preview. Okay, this is for 40. I will change again into 15. Preview. Okay, I will change into 1. Preview. Okay, this is for 1. You can close and okay. Next, we head again with a new pattern. Okay, for grass. Okay, we search for grass. You can use this option or this option. I will use this grass. Okay, and pick points. I will click at this point. Enter. You can click preview. Okay, this for preview. I will change scale in here into 15. And enter. Okay. Now for this WC, you can hatch again. Okay, I will change pattern in here. Okay, we can use this pattern. Okay, pick point, click at this point, and in here, enter. You can type a preview, click preview. Okay, I will change scale in here into 25. Okay, next you can click OK to apply. We can change this colors, this pattern color into green. Okay, and we change again this pattern color into grand can. Okay. And the last, we can create a dimension into this floor plan. You can tap D to open a dimension style manager and click modify. Okay, for primary units, I will use a 0 in here. And then for text, we can change into green. For text height, 150. Vertical offset, 50. Okay. Now for symbol and arrows, I will change in here into architectural tick. And then for arrow size, 100. In here, I will change into 30. Okay, for break size to 100. Okay, and it's okay. You can change line in here. I will change colors into red. Okay, and for baseline spacing to 100, change into red, in here 50, and dimension line 100. You can click OK, close. You can use dim linear to create dimension linear. Okay, start from this point into this point. We create again from this point into here. Okay, and from this point into this point. Okay, 6000. Next, we create from this point into M2P. Okay, we use the M2P option. You can click in here and click in here. Okay, in here 5000. Okay, we create again from this point into M2P. Okay, click in here and click in here. Click at this point. Okay, we create stuff from this point into this point. Click at this point. Next, in the top, you can click in here and use M2P option again. Click at this point into here and move to this point. Next, we click in here into this point and in here. Okay, now at the left here, we create from this point with M to P. Okay, click in here and in here, and put in here. Okay, we create from this point into M to P. Okay, click in here, first point, second point, and click in here. Okay, you can use a scroll mouse button to zoom in and zoom out. Okay, in GWCAD software, almost same like AutoCAD command. Okay, the last we create stuff from this point into this point, and then from this point into this point. Okay, next we can edit this dimension object. Okay, we edit again in here. Okay, in here. Okay, in the top, and then in the right here. Okay. Okay, very easy to create this 2D floor plan in GWCAD software. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video. And see you next time in another GWCAD basic tutorial.